Hello and welcome to this new Developer Quick Takes episode. My name is Philippe Oziel. I'm a developer evangelist at Salesforce. And today I'm going to present how you can enable Jest Code Coverage Overlay in Visual Studio Code. Before I jump into the specifics of the installation instructions, I want to remind you what Jest is. Jest is a JavaScript testing framework, and we use Jest with a plugin to test Lightning Web Components. Now, there are two things that make this installation a bit more trickier than it should be. First, we need to configure the usage of the plugin. And secondly, we also need to use an alpha version of the overlay as of July 2020. Normally, you would install the Jest extension directly from the VS Code marketplace. But since we need an alpha version, we need to go to the project homepage on GitHub. And you can see here it's vscode-jest. Now, on this page, we have several releases, and the latest stable release at the time of recording of this video, which is end of July 2020, is version 3.2.0. But this is not what we need. We need to go into the other releases, and we need to pick a version 4. Currently, the only version 4 that is available is an alpha version, but that's perfectly fine. It's stable enough that we can use it. So how do we install this alpha version? The alpha version is not yet on the marketplace, but we have an option to install it manually. And if you scroll down on the release page, you can see here there are a bunch of assets that are provided as part of the version. And you can see here there's a Vsix file, which is the installation itself packaged as a file. So I'm going to click on this to download the file. And you can click also on this link here, which gives you the instructions on how to install the extension from the Vsix file. It's pretty simple. I'm going to click on the link here and you can see the instructions are simply to run this command here with code dash dash install extension, then the extension file. All right, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to open a terminal and I'm going to install the extension. All right, I am now in my terminal. I'm ready to install. Before installing, I made sure that I've closed VS Code in order to avoid conflicts. Now I can go ahead and type code dash dash install extension. Space, then the name of the extension file. So that's vscode-jest, the version, and .vsix. Now, as a reminder, this works because I'm in the downloads folder where I saved my extension. I'm going to hit enter. This is going to install the extension. This is pretty quick, by the way. I can now create a new Salesforce DX project for the sake of a demonstration. So sfdx force project create. And I'm going to provide a name, just going to call it demo. All right. So this is a really a clean slate project. This is a good reference to get the installation instructions right. I'm going to open this project now with Visual Studio Code with code demo, because my folder name is demo. All right. And here we are. We are in a really clean project. At this point, just code coverage overlay will not work. So we need to do a couple more steps before we can activate the extension. So what I'm going to do first is that I'm going to open terminal window by going on the top menu. I'm going to open it directly in the IDE so we can see everything here. And I need to actually install the load project dependencies that are contained in package.json. To do that, I run npm install, and this will fetch all dependencies. So you'll see a bunch of warnings and errors, but nothing really serious here. And now our project is installed, and you can now see there's a node module folder here. All right, now that our project is installed, the next thing we need to do is to add something to be tested. So we're working right now on an empty project, and you can see there are no Lightning Web components. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take component from another application. This is called Lightning Web Components Recipes, and I'm going to drop that in our project folder. This is a really basic component with a very limited amount of code that we're going to use to demonstrate testing and code coverage for Jest. Now that this is done, we have something to test. We also need to configure the Jest project. By default, Jest tests only vanilla JavaScript, but our project is a bit more specific. It's a Lightning Web Components project. So we need to configure Jest so that it knows that it needs to use a particular Jest plugin to test Lightning Web Components. Now, I also need a configuration file that I'm going to take from one of the other applications I have running, for example, Lightning Web Components Recipes, and I'm going to drop that in our project. This particular configuration file is always named jest.config.js, and this is the a standard name for Jest configuration. It needs to be at the root of the project, and what we're looking at right now is the minimum configuration that needs to be added to make the Lightning Web Components Jest plugin work. So what does it do? It's a JavaScript configuration file. It imports the plugin configuration. Here we can see the name of the plugin, which is SFDX LWC Jest. And it takes the configuration and it adds it to the default Jest configuration. By default, Jest will always look for jest.config.js file and load configuration from there. So what we did essentially here is that we added the configuration for our plugin to the default Jest configuration. And this is extremely important because if Jest does not find this file, it will not know how to handle Lightning Web Components tests. Now that this is done, we need another thing. We need to actually enable Git for our project. The extension use Jest watch mode. So it's basically scanning our code for changes. And each time the code changes, it reruns the test. But in order to run the watch mode, there's a dependency on Git. So whether you use it for version control or not doesn't matter, but you need to set up the Git project. So what you need to type here in the console is git init. You don't need to integrate with a remote repository, you just need to run git init so that we have the minimum git structure folder, and this lets the Jest extension work. At this point, I need to restart my VS Code editor. So what's new here is this Jest status bar here at the bottom of VS Code, and you can see that it's running some things and starting watch mode, running some tests, and this means the extension is doing its job. Now, it will stop with this particular status, meaning that test has passed, and you can click on it to get a detailed status of the test reports. Now, let's take a look at what our test says. I'm gonna open the JavaScript file of our Lightning Web Component, and we're gonna check what happens to it. Right now, it's not showing anything. The overlay is not showing because by default, it is disabled. So what we're gonna do now is that we're gonna toggle it. To do that, I'm gonna use the command palette of Visual Studio Code with a command shift P on a Mac or Windows shift P on a Windows machine. Now in the menu, you'll have to type Jest to bring in this command here, Jest toggle code coverage overlay. And here for me, it's the first option because I've ran this quite a few times, but it may not be the first one for you. Now I'm going to hit enter to select it. And this is going to rerun the tests. And here we go. We now have the code coverage overlay showing up. So in this particular instance, I have one line here, which is not covered. You can see it's highlighted in red. And I can also see here that I have the overall file coverage with detailed stats. Now, what's interesting is that if you have full coverage, you won't see any overlay. Just to let you know, the covered code is not highlighted in green. So don't expect to see anything if you have full coverage. You'll always see, however, this top line. Now, let's try to fix our code coverage. What I didn't tell you before is that I have purposefully limited the tests. So I'm gonna open the test file here on the side. Let me rearrange my windows so we can see everything in one single screen. So we now have the code we test on the left and our test code on the right. On the testing code side, we have a test that passes. You can see here that we have a little green check mark, which marks the test is passing. We can also run this test individually. And if I scroll down, you'll notice here that I have disabled a test. I comment this out specifically to get line coverage miss here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to uncomment this other test. And since Jest is running in watch mode, as soon as I save my file here, it's going to rerun Jest coverage. And you can see here it's rerunning again at the bottom. And there we go. The red marker has gone. And you can see now that my updated code coverage is 100%. That's how you set up Jest code coverage overlay in VS Code. I hope that you found these instructions useful and that you're going to enjoy this extension. I'll probably re-edit this video once VS Code extension is available in a non-alpha version. It'll be even simpler to install it from the marketplace. Thanks for watching! If you learned something new today, make sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this, push directly to you, click subscribe and that bell to get notifications.